Hey, what's going on, YouTube family? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Mark. Please remember to slash that like button. And if you're new here, please remember to annihilate that subscribe button. And also, hit that post notification bell. Let's just jump straight into these videos. Let's go.
They call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't a...
Justin Adams. This is my first time hearing of Justin Adams. I can't wait to see what he brings.
I'll be your CEO day.
Oh, okay. Come on.
I stand up legs swinging on the tailgate.
Come on.
The old days and fist fights.
I want to sit there and say that I felt that when... When Justin came on there with the vocals, I felt that. Like, I wanted to go back to the old days. He killed that coming on here. Let me take that back. Okay, so I want to know, is our brother Upchurch about to get vocals too? Or is he going to just rip and annihilate it by rapping? I want this vest, Upchurch. That's all I got to say is I want that vest. That vest, I like that vest.
There's a bridge on River Road where I painted my name.
Woo!
With a couple of buddies with John Deere spray paint. We used to smoke on the green after the sun hit the hay and made it home by nine on Daddy's temper would blaze.
Oh, come on.
Door shit, we were straight out the back, sitting in a distance, chewing red men up by the back. Them straight pipes on the 5-7 made us feel badass. Sitting in the senior parking lot, cranking up Johnny Cash.
Oh, come on. And I want to pause it again real quickly and just sit here and say that I love how Church is giving me like almost like an autobiography to me of like his life and taking me back in time to when he was a kid and a child growing up. I think that that is well executed and it's amazing because it really fits the title of the song, The Old Days, because it sets the stage and sets the tone to place you in a place where it's like you're reminiscing and you're reflecting. And that's what I get from him, especially even with these visuals as well, because it's almost like he's given, like he's almost going back in time and just reflecting on the good old days when he was a child and like him just wanting to go back to when he was innocent and just like pure and just like when, like where he didn't have to sit there and give a shit about anything in the world, where he didn't have to deal with like all the outside added drama or pressure that adults have to sit there and deal with. Like when you're a kid, you're able to escape and you're able to place yourself within this box and in this bubble, and that's what I feel like that he's given us. He's laying this foundation to do that, and I just love his passion and his drive and his execution with this song of being able to lay that foundation, if that makes sense. Let me jump back into this. I'm gonna take it back a little bit.
In the distance, you and red men up by the breath. Them straight pipes on the 5-7 made us feel badass. Sitting in the senior parking lot.
I want that jacket too. Is that a jacket or is that? I want that.
Right, but my heart is nothing but gold. Hospitality's priceless. It ain't about trading a soul.
Ooh.
So before you judge my cover, won't you dive in my soul?
Oh, come on.
Life, I'm like 200 years old. I'll be your CEO days. Tall Chevrolet. Swinging on a tailgate, the
Can I just sit here and say that my brother Upchurch make me want to be from Tennessee? Like, I don't even want to, I just want to tell everybody I'm from Tennessee right now, or from going on, because I love how he is so, like, content and so confident and just, like, so proud of where he comes from. I love that authenticity, and it just shows and oozes through his music. I love that so much about him, because he's so authentically himself. And I know I say that in so many reactions, but I just can't help but to sit there and just reiterate it for people who may just come across my videos. This is why I love Upchurch, and this is why I'm such a huge fan of his now, and I'm so happy that my subscribers have introduced me to him, because I love artists who are authentically themselves, and they are not scared to showcase who they are without giving a fuck what anybody else has to sit there and say about them. And that's what I love about him. So let's jump back into this.
Muddy water in my veins, hellish nights on Indian Springs, praying I would catch my dreams. Ooh. I went to heaven, let me tell ya, I was lost in life. Almost got fronted them bells to help keep on my family's life. But then I walked to a church in the midst of the night. Put some tears on the tulips and the creation was bright. And I knew at that very moment the fight I was about to pick involved cowboy boots, guitars, and not giving a shit. So let me write to the beat of my two clicks. Tony Llamas, live in a trailer with my family and a few saved up dollars.
Oh, come on. Amazing. That was like the most amazing collab I've seen right now. Like, that was phenomenal. Upchurch, you have to do another collab with Justin Adams. I just think that you guys' chemistry is absolutely insane and amazing when you guys, how you guys just jumped on this track and annihilated the old days. But let me just jump into my review right quick, and I want to first start off with Justin Adams, because this is my first time hearing of this brother, and I thought he did an absolutely phenomenal job with the vocals. Like, I really felt each and every thing that he was sitting there saying through his vocal ability and the way that he was projecting his voice. It was almost like I was being sacrificed, almost like I was like a sacrificial lamb listening to his voice, because it was so angelic. It was so, like, filled with passion, filled with raw emotion, not just emotion, because there's a difference between emotion and raw emotion. And I really felt his raw emotion, like he was sitting there, like, wanting to get back to the old days of when life was sweet, when he didn't have to sit there and worry about anything, where he didn't have a care in the world, where he didn't feel like he had to struggle, where he didn't feel like life was a bitch and was throwing lemons at him. Like, I really felt like he wanted to go back to the good old sweet old days, to where life made sense and where this life wasn't like a game of chance or like lottery, where it's like maybe you win, maybe you don't. And that's what I got from Justin Adams, the way he sat there and was able to showcase his vocal ability. His vocal ability is so phenomenal, was so precise, was so amazing. And it's like, I don't want to sit there and be sacrilegious and say that it's like almost like if you think of like the Passion of the Christ being nailed to the, being bared to a cross. But that's what I almost felt like he was, like what was happening is that he was like, he was bearing his cross and just letting out everything. Like, he was sitting there, like almost sitting there sacrificing himself for the sins of everybody, because he wanted to go back in time and just relive those precious and good moments. I loved it. Now let's talk about our brother Upchurch with this masterpiece that he came through with, these bars and these lyrics, and just everything about it was like so autobiographical. Like, I felt like I was being taken back in time. Like, and just to be able to learn so much about him through his music and his artistry, I think it's so amazing, because you can tell he's so transparent with his fans, and he's not trying to be, like I always sit there and say, he's not trying to be something he's not. Like, he's a, like, you could tell he's a very, what you see is what you get kind of guy. Either you like me and that's cool, or he's like, you don't like me and you can do this. Like he's just gonna pretty much do that. Sorry, I'm sticking my middle fingers up. It's not to any of you who's watching, but I just feel like that's like the type of attitude that he has, and I love that, because he's so confident and so content in who he is as a person that he doesn't feel like he has to appease anybody else. He's not trying to be the next Eminem, or he's not trying to be one of the next Rolling Stones or like Led Zeppelin or just like anybody, like Adam Levine or like just 50 Cent or who else can you think of, like Lloyd Banks or Nas or just Tupac or somebody. He wants to be Upchurch, and then he wants to solidify and make his own brand where he can sit there and have other people that come before, after him, that come across him and be like, I feel like he's painting this lane where people can look up to him. I know if I was growing up, and me being from the city, me being from New York City and sitting here listening to him, and growing up, if I was a kid, I would be like, I want to be like him. Like, and that's just me telling the truth and being honest, because I love how transparent he is. I love how authentic he is. And I love that he's carving his own niche and not trying to be somebody he's not. And he's trying to create a standard. He's not trying to follow a standard. He's not trying to follow a brand. He's not trying to follow a blueprint. He is the blueprint, and he wants to sit there and lay the foundation of a blueprint, so where other kids that come after him can be like, yo, I want to be like Upchurch. And I know if I was a kid, and if I had a kid, I would want my kid to be like Upchurch, somebody who's not afraid to be authentically themselves, whether you're from Anchorage, Alaska, or you're from LA or New York City, or whether you're from like Biloxi, Mississippi. Be proud of who you are and where you come from. And I love that he's so proud of who he is and where he comes from, and he doesn't deviate from that. He doesn't shy away from that. He's not afraid to be himself. And I just think that he's an amazing artist, and that's why I'm a proud Creeker. and I'm a proud member of the Creek Squad because I just think he's absolutely phenomenal, and he sits in his truth of who he is as an artist, and I think he does a phenomenal job. But Church, you have to do like another collab with Justin Adams, because I thought that this was absolutely phenomenal. So please let me know what you thought of Old Days by Upchurch featuring Justin Adams in the comments below. And like I always sit there and say, I do not rate musical genius, because how can you do that when it's put on full display? And this man is Einstein when it comes to versatility and showcasing musical capability and vocal talent and just bars and everything. And like I said, and I mean every word that I said, that if I had a son, I would want my son to mold himself after Upchurch, because I love the upstanding guy that he is and the role model that he is and the truth that he sits in, which is himself, and he doesn't deviate from that. So with that being said, please remember to be safe out there. Remember to stay awesome. Be awesome, because you guys are all awesome. This is your boy Mark, and I'm signing off. Deuces. Peace.
They call me Megatron. Shorty's a Megacon. It ain't about the race either. It's a marathon.